Okay, everybody, let's talk about Unreal Editor for Fortnite. Brand new out a couple days ago, and it is utterly amazing. If you are not a gamer, not into tech, not into Fortnite, all the same, you've got to check this out. It is just incredible the way you can create worlds. So we're in Unreal Editor for Fortnite. It's the beta version. Here and there, it'll crash. It's going to hit done on here, and it's going to open up a screen that says, these are all your projects you've been working on. And I've just been working on some basic stuff here and there. But we're going to go into the island templates. And you can make this bigger if you want to. Just go like that. And all of these different kinds of islands we can start with. We're actually going to start with blank. I really encourage you, if you're just getting into this, start with a blank template. It'll give you an idea of how to sort of build from scratch. Once you get into building from scratch, you're like, oh, I don't know, this is kind of taking a little while. Or how do they build those certain things? Go ahead and check out the demo maps and see how they are built. But we're going to go to blank, hit create. Okay, so what this is doing is creating a bunch of files on your hard drive that it's going to then connect to revision control, because it does that by default. Revision control is essentially a way for it to remember how you built a thing. And keep track of that. So when we first come into a world like this, we're going to see two spawning beacons, players, team one and team two, or player one and player two. These don't matter. Don't worry about them. We're going to scroll out, or if you want to go a little bit quicker, up here in the right-hand corner is the camera speed. I've set mine to 6. And then what you do is use the mouse button, the middle mouse button to go up and down like this, and the right mouse button to tilt and pan. And then you can use your arrow keys to zoom way out, whatever direction you're facing. So if you use the right mouse button to kind of move around and rotate around and stuff like that, and your camera is set up to speed 6 like mine is, you'll zip around all over the place, which is really handy, probably kind of dizzying. Anyway, so here's our guys. We're going to just zoom out. I'm going to just use my arrow keys to zoom way out. And this is our world. This is the base world that they give you when you have a blank canvas. Now, don't worry. This gets really cool. Check us out. So right now, if we look up here, we're in selection mode. Selection mode is a way of selecting stuff. So if we come back down and we take a look, we can select one of these little guys here, and then stuff over here will change. Don't worry about this. This is the outliner. We'll get to this in a little bit. Maybe not this tutorial, but coming up. And that allows you to select stuff. We don't want to select stuff. What we want to do is we want to create our world. So we're going to go into landscape mode. Landscape mode is fantastic because it already sort of figures out this is where our world is. It's going to create a landscape based off of these grids right here. So on the left-hand side, we can see we're in landscape mode. If you don't see this Creative Landscape Apollo standard, like say, for example, let's switch it to this. And so this is a bounds solid for traps. It's really weird. You would never use this. You're thinking, how do I get back to the thing? Just hit this default button right here. Go to the default value. It's going to set it up to be the rocks and the grass. Nothing really to change in here. I wouldn't worry about too much of this. Just go ahead and hit create. Okay, so what that does is it creates this landscape. Now, it's all the same. If we zoom back in, we can still see our little dudes. Whoops, I've come too far. Just scroll out a little. You see all of our grasses here, all of our the usual stuff that we're going to see. I'm just going to come out of the ground here. And our little guys here are sitting a little low. So if we want to, we can go back to selection mode or hit shift 1, grab our little guys, and they're going to have these little gizmos on them. A gizmo is sort of a 3D marking tool. And I'm just using my mouse right now to scroll around. I scroll in and out with the scroll wheel, right mouse button, again, tilts and pans, and the middle mouse button holding it down will go sort of in and out. All right. So this gizmo here allows us, if we click on the guy again, we'll just drag upwards. So that's on the Z-axis. We're going to be talking about this a lot. Z-axis means up and down. The Y-axis is for this direction and this direction, and the x-axis, which is going to be red. Let's bring this up so you can see it a little clearer. And we'll zoom in. Something like that. All right. So the blue one is for Z. That goes up and down. The red one is for X. Goes this way and that way. And the Y one goes this way and this way. So we're going to put them back down on the ground. Somewhere there. Now, I actually should mention really quickly before we get into any more landscaping business. If you find that your computer is reacting really slowly, sometimes choppy or even crashes. I had piles of crashes. And the way I was able to solve that was just go into my settings and go into the engine scalable settings item and hit auto. If you do this, it's going to try to sort out what your computer can handle. And then once you've done that, just bring down the resolution scale another 10% or so. And that will give it good performance overall. I mean, it'll already be at wherever Fortnite thinks it should be for good performance, but I like mine to be a little bit quicker. So let's grab this guy and just drag him up as well, just for funsies. So what the landscape mode has done is it has created a landscape for you. So just going back into landscape mode, I'm going to zoom way out and we're going to see we've got this. Now, to make stuff in landscape mode, we are going to use the sculpt. So you go to manage and that just did the thing that we did before. Sculpt goes into how we're going to make stuff. So right now we've got a brush type that is just the normal brush type, a brush fall off, which means how smoothly it falls off. Now I've got my brush fall off set to 1. So let's move this over here. And you can see there's an inner circle and an outer circle. I'm going to change my brush fall off to really high. And you see how the circles are almost the exact same. But if I come way in here and put it down to 0, or sorry, no, let's go to 0. Let's go to 0.1 or something like that. You can see that they're very close. And we bring it up to 0.8. Doesn't matter. Somewhere around there. It's a little different. You can see that the inner circle is really small and the big circle is really big. So let's do a demonstration of this. So I'm going to just hit the left mouse button. I've got a tool strength of 0.3 right now. It's pretty strong, to be honest. So we're just going to hold, and you can see the mountain that I create with that. Now, if we bring the fall off down to, say, 0.1, and we come over here and we make another mountain, it goes like that. So you see, the fall off is how much the ramping of the land will be. So I usually have it fall off pretty high because I don't like to, I'm not generally going to be creating this stuff. And if we want to smooth that out, we can hit the smooth button and just sort of scrub around on it, or the flatten button, which will sort of flatten out the areas. And then we make just a big hill kind of thing. We can come over here and flatten this a little bit and then go ahead and smooth a little bit. Like that, and it'll just modify it ever so amazingly. I mean, this is just insane how quickly this all kind of comes together. And go back to sculpting and put a little ramp in between these two hills, maybe. It'll make sense, right? And then you can come way out and say, well, what did I just create? And just zoom way out and see what you think of your terrain. So for the first step of getting into Unreal Engine Fortnite gaming map editor, I highly recommend you just do these basic steps. Wander in, create yourself a landscape, go ahead and start sculpting, erasing. You can erase stuff as well, right? We can smooth that out a bit and flatten it. Everything can become flatter and just raise it up. So it's going to just flatten everything out. We can even flatten this whole mountain out. Bam, just like that. And then come back in and maybe sculpt something out in the middle here, right? And we'll get into all the other ones in another one. We're going to do erosion. Erosion is going to make it look like water came along and eroded some stuff away. And we get back down to, this is where we have to be kind of careful because we're going to get down to our base level. We don't want to be down there. So we'll just quickly sculpt in a bit of land here. And that's looking pretty good for a start. So go ahead and start playing with that. Play around with the tool strength. If you put the strength way up and you press the button, it's going to come up really, really fast. You bring your strength way down, something like that, and it's going to come up really, really slow. I'm just holding the mouse button down. You see how slowly that comes up. All right. And don't worry too much maybe about the fall-off stuff. That just changes the shape of your brush and how it's going to create a thing. See how this is much flatter on top than this one because it's a different fall-off. Here's a spherical fall-off. So if we make another one just over here perhaps, and you can see how it's more roundy on the top. Rather, this one's kind of flat and this one's sort of a little bit sharper. And this one I'll create an even sharper one. Just go like this. Yeah, so that's what those are about. You can make all kinds of terrain inside of here. So that's what I recommend starting with, just getting used to it. Make sure that your settings for performance are good. You can definitely make things go much faster or much slower based on what you've got. Remember, you're just creating in here, so you're not playing, so you don't need everything to be epic or cinematic. It can just be pretty good. You can actually just set everything to medium and you probably do really well for creating. It's going to respond really quickly depending on your computer, or even just straight down all the way down to low. And you can see how it changes. You know, everything changes to a much more basic shade of the material. So if we just take a look here, we're in low right now. Let's go ahead. I'll just give you guys an idea so you know what we're looking at. Just switch to medium, start to get some grass, switch to high, get more grass, switch to epic, and it's even more detailed, and then cinematic just goes nuts. And if it doesn't crash, I'd be surprised. So I just go back to auto, like I said, it'll do a check, and then I just bring my resolution scale down just a smidge, just to make it a little quicker. So there you go. Bunch of tips, how to get started with UEFN. This is an absolutely fantastic program to try to use for making levels inside of Fortnite. So give it a go, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.